Good morning. Can you guys hear me at the back? Should I take my pitch up or pitch down? Okay. I'm really thankful to the organizers for inviting me to be with all of you. And I'm supposed to speak on what works in leadership. I'll start with two stories which you might have heard in the past, but nevertheless, I would like to repeat them. One is about Tom Watson Jr. and the other is about Thomas Edison. Both these stories illustrate how the great leaders deal with adversity. Tom Watson Jr. was the CEO of IBM Corporation between 1956 and 1971. He was one of the key figures in the IT revolution that has taken place in this world. In the IBM, there was one young executive who goofed up and made a mistake which cost IBM several million dollars. And this young executive was called by Tom Watson in his office. Now, as this executive entered the office, first thing that he said was, "I guess I'm going to be fired." And that was an obvious reaction from him, saying that he was invited to get fired. And there was a very interesting reaction from Mr. Watson. And what did he say? "Not at all, young man. We have just spent a couple of million dollars on your education. It's an investment. How can I fire you?" So this story provides us a few strong messages. One is, you got to support your people. So that's one big message. And second thing is, adversity or failures teach you a lot. Don't get disheartened by adversity. Learn from it. And I think that's a great example that we picked up from Tom Watson Jr. I'm sure all of you remember the famous quote of that you will guess, "I have not failed. I have not failed. I've just found 10,000 different ways of not doing work or that wouldn't work." And that is something which is an amazing story from Thomas Edison, who invented the electric bulb. Again, that was a great response to the adversity. 10,000 experiments didn't work. At some stage it worked and we got the bulb. When Edison's factory got burnt down completely, just imagine what must have been the plight of Edison. But Edison said, "There is a great value in disaster. All our mistakes are burned up. Now I can start afresh and have a clean slate." What does it tell you? That leadership is not about skills. Leadership is not about knowledge. Leadership is all about your attitude. And I think I'm going to speak for next 10-15 minutes on this whole issue of attitude. All of you are young people. It's so easy for you in today's world to acquire knowledge. It is so easy for you to develop skills, the whole lot of training programs, 1 day, 2 days programs, communication skills, presentation skills, walking skills, talking skills, all kinds of skills. And you can pick up those skills very easily on your way. You can acquire knowledge very easily. Very difficult to develop right attitude, which will enable you take up leadership positions. As Dr. Chellappa rightly said, you don't need to be you don't need to be an MBA to be a leader. What you need is the right attitude. What you need is the right attitude and right behavior. So both these stories that we talked about, they talk about the essential characteristics of leadership, and there are a lot of lessons to learn. So right attitudes and beliefs can be easily developed. only if you have an open mind, a mind that keeps challenging your own existing beliefs, it keeps reviewing your mistakes of the past and keeps taking course corrective action. So leaders don't necessarily are born. They are the guys who are on a constant interaction mode, and they need to be coached and not necessarily trained into a classroom. So look for a good coach who will help you become good leaders. So whenever a business or an individual decides that success has been attained, the progress stops. So develop an attitude of lifelong learning if you really want to be great leaders. Now, in the process, I also want to say, be proud of your achievements. Celebrate success, but sustenance of a success, sustenance of leadership depends entirely on you being having humility and absence of ego. And the ego is one of the worst things to happen. Ego kills your ability to learn and ability to have an open mind. Because I will say, I have arrived. I have everything that I know. I am successful. I don't need to learn anything more. The moment you develop that attitude, your progress stops. And the moment the progress stops, the decline starts. So great leaders continuously want to improve and better their performance. And that is again a mindset, and that's again an attitude that we need to have. Please appreciate, you are all young and you have very long careers ahead of you. And these careers are never smooth curves. They are always with ups and downs. And that's a reality of life. Now, while you are going up, celebrate, enjoy, but with lot of humility and modesty. I think that's most important. But when you are going down, don't get disheartened, because this is only a temporary phase. Be courageous and be determined and come out of it. Because after the downtrend, it's going to be up curve. You got to constantly prepare yourself. From every downturn, there's a lot to learn. Learn and start going up. Never give up. I think that's another very important quality of a great leader. Leaders never give up. They are constantly at it. Success consists of going from failure to failure without loss of enthusiasm. You know whose quote is this? This is Winston Churchill. He said, success consists of going from one failure to another failure without loss of enthusiasm. And you know what Churchill achieved. He was a great leader at the right time. So I want to also quote Edison to you. Many of life failures are men who did not realize how close they were to success when they gave up. And Edison himself is a live example of that. So leaders don't get disheartened with failures. When a person who has never made mistakes has never discovered anything. In fact, my father used to always tell me, and I think that is a great lesson that I learned, and he used to say, if you want to be a asadharan vyakti, do you all understand what is asadharan? Do you want to be an asadharan vyakti, sadharan things will not help you. I mean, anyone and everyone, everybody does this, so I will do it. The moment you do that, then you will be like everybody. If you want to be asadharan, that is different from others, you will have to do some asadharan things. Actually, asadharan things are most difficult things to do, because they are not something which other normal people do. And that needs lot of courage. Actually, again, I want to quote Tom Watson. He says, every time we have moved ahead in IBM, It was because someone was willing to take a chance, put his head on the chopping block and try something new. Now, to put your head on a chopping block, you need huge courage and belief in your own self. And again, that's an attitudinal issue. So for leadership, attitudes count far more than anything else. So what we are going to do is talk about some attitudes which are absolutely necessary for leaders. Now, some leaders are described as having bad attitude. And what is that bad attitude? Let's spend 1 minute talking about it. Bad attitude is all about pessimism. I can't do it. I'm not capable of doing it. This won't work. This whole pessimistic kind of a mindset ensures that you will never grow as a leader. Next is laziness. Laziness ensures that you will never grow as leaders. Rudeness. I don't know why people are rude, but many people are rude, and rudeness doesn't help. What doesn't help is also gossips. We end up spending huge amount of time in corridors spreading rumors and talking about people and personalities and get into gossips. That doesn't help. Procrastination is one of the biggest enemies of leadership. Procrastination also doesn't help. A lot of us are cynical, and cynicism doesn't help. The whole negativity doesn't help. So if you really want to be leaders, just review within yourselves and figure out if you have any of these unfortunate qualities and just get rid of them. Because a negative attitude is contagious. It spreads like a virus very, very fast. And a negative leader brings negativity in the organization. And these are very costly people to have in the corporations. And corporations would like to get these negative people out as early as possible. Please understand, the greatest freedom is the freedom of choice that you and me have. And that choice is of having right attitude and right behaviors. And I think that is a choice that we must exercise. And nobody can stop us from having a positive, right attitude. So let's describe and let's talk about 4 or 5 critical attitudes that will enable all of you to become leaders. Number one, leaders are not yes men. I think that is something which we got to keep in mind. Few years back, actually, probably a couple of decades back, maybe 40 years back, when I started my career, organizations had concepts of loyalty, and which really meant that you are in complete conformity with your boss. You will not disagree with him, you will not argue with him, you will listen to boss patiently and follow what your boss tells you to do. Disagreements were never encouraged and supported. But with the change of times, when the world is becoming far more competitive, it is discovered that it is important to have opinions of several people. In today's world, conformity for the sake of conformity is not appreciated. So speak out your mind, talk it over. If you don't like a thing, get into proper logical arguments. Please understand that you got to create value and you've got to be different from others. Conformity is not necessarily a right characteristic of becoming a good leader. And it's not easy to be a non-conformist, because a non-conformist needs to have huge conviction in what he or she is speaking. So do you have the conviction in your thoughts? Do you believe what you're speaking is right? Is it well thought out? Is it well studied? And do you have the ability to influence? Like Dr. Chalappa talked about influencing skills. So don't be a yes man is the first quality of being a good leader. My experience with good leaders is they are risk takers. They take risks. they really try to go into the areas which others have not dared to go. And risk-taking again demands that you have conviction and you have the ability to be sure of what you are doing. Actually, if you really look at organizations, there are typically four layers of organization. The lowest level, you will find individual contributors, and I guess most of you will start as individual contributors, getting into managing certain processes that exist in the company. You go to the second layer of hierarchy. These are the people who are kind of supervisors of these individual contributors. Again, these are not typically the leadership roles, but these are managerial roles wherein you are managing these individual contributors. And go to the next level, and these are the middle managers who are managing the supervisors and managing the processes. The top leadership roles are at the much next fourth level or higher. Now, does that mean that we do not need leadership qualities at the bottom level? We do need leadership qualities at the bottom level, who will be the people who will be creative thinkers, who will say, this is not right, I don't like it, let's change it, let's reinvent ourselves. And most of the innovation and creativity that happens is happening at the bottom level, who are constantly reinventing new processes, new methods, and new ways of working. And I think you got to have that ability to begin with of self-conviction, challenging, questioning, and changing. And that is where you get spotted as the people who can really grow into the hierarchy. Another most important part, and I'm going to depend on what Dr. Chalabha said, and I'm not going to spend much time, is all about having right social skills and skills to influence. Now, you can influence only if you are known to the person whom you are trying to influence. So first and the foremost, you need to have social skills, ability to mix with people at all levels of hierarchy, and from bottom to the top. Don't be status conscious. A leader is never status conscious. He's conscious of the goals and targets that he has to achieve. He doesn't care for status. He walks across organizational boundaries. He gets work done from wherever it is required and wherever it is possible. So don't be hierarchy driven. Be a person who has great social skills, who can influence based on his knowledge. Now, influencing, amongst other things, comes from your own credibility. And the credibility of great past performance, credibility of your knowledge, and application of knowledge on the job. Please appreciate, today knowledge is easily available. Knowledge is no more power. But power comes from application of knowledge. And that is where you develop credibility. And once you have demonstrated your credibility, your ability to influence grows up leaps and bounds. And that's a positive method of influencing. And we got to develop those skills. So I think this developing influencing skills and developing high level of credibility in order to do that, and having great social skills, is a critical, again, element for leadership. Then let's talk about what do other leaders do. Leaders are always strategic. They are future focused. It's so easy to get involved into your day-to-day routine that many a times as you get into your jobs, you will stop asking questions, why am I doing this? Does it really help? Is it important? Because we are all busy managing processes day in and day out. But somewhere you've got to take a pause and challenge and question what you are doing. Is it critical for the company? A good leader will always have his antennas up. He's constantly focused on what's happening in the environment and figuring it out whether it's appropriate for the corporation. Look at organizations who completely failed because being too much inwardly focused and not aware of what the environment is doing. I've got great example of Nokia, which completely bombed. Nokia was one of the best products that probably existed about 7, 8, 9 years back, I think all of us would have used those Nokia phones, very reliable. What happened to that company? Somewhere, the strategic focus of ensuring that I don't only have good products for today, but I must have right products for tomorrow. Somewhere that strategic focus got lost. Somewhere that innovation and creativity got lost. So if you really want to be a leader, you've got to be focused on future on a constant basis and ensure that you are constantly scanning the environment. Another example of company that lost out was Eastman Kodak. I mean, that company which had such lovely products, great market reach, superb brand equity, that company just completely failed because it could not see the digital revolution that was coming up, and they never reinvented. Actually, they had probably the first digital cameras in place, but they were never convinced with their own products. As a result of that, that great corporation just lost it out. So creativity, innovation, constantly being focused on future and not worrying about your past only is something which is again is a hallmark of a group leadership. Leaders' next attitude is they take responsibility. While they delegate, they do not abdicate. They are constantly saying, I am responsible. When it comes to success, they give credit to all their team members. But when it comes to failures, they say, I am accountable, I am responsible, and I will deal with it. They are never disheartened. When they say, we have failed, they will say, we have learned something today. What is it that we need to do? And they keep moving on. In fact, there was a very interesting thing that I thought I must speak. Great leaders see themselves as victors over circumstances rather than victims of circumstances. They don't criticize or blame others, but they learn from the failures. Another most important part, and I think that is something which all of us have to do if we want to grow into leadership, focus on execution. I think somewhere, dreaming, having great vision, having great strategic plans, all those are important. But if there is no good execution, nothing works. So I think we have to focus a lot on execution. At the beginning of the year, how many of you make great New Year resolutions? Like I make a resolution, I want to reduce 10 kg weight in next 6 months' time. Great resolution to make. Having made that resolution, I go and consult a dietitian, and I go and consult a gym expert, and I go and consult a yoga expert. I get a whole lot of ideas, information, and knowledge. Having got all that, execution with complete rigor and discipline is something all within me. Otherwise, having a great resolution, having great ideas and knowledge and information doesn't help alone. So execution becomes very important. And in corporate world, the speed of execution counts a lot. So execution skills, I think we need to all develop. And leaders are positive. And I think we talked about negative aspects of leadership, but let's talk about positive aspects. In fact, leaders are in the business of energy. Think about it. We have to be energetic ourselves, and we have to create energy around us. So in order to remain energetic, we got to be constantly charged, we got to be constantly motivated, and we can't depend on anyone to motivate us. No outsider can motivate me, no outsider can charge me. I have to do it myself, it's all within me. And unless I am energetic, unless I am motivated, unless I am agile, I cannot make people below me energetic, agile, and charged. So a leader has to be a role model in this area. Last, and I'll just spend 1 minute more, leaders don't focus on becoming popular. We are not film stars. We are not politicians. We are business executives. Leaders are focused on effectiveness. Leaders are focused on doing the right things. All of you in your lives will have to take tough decisions as well as good decisions. So don't be shy of taking tough decisions. Develop that emotional strength to take tough decisions, difficult decisions. I think that's absolutely crucial, because tough decisions make you learn a lot, develop your emotional muscle powers. So focus on effectiveness, focus on becoming respectable, but don't focus on becoming popular. And I think that is another important message. So in conclusions, the leaders are the people who have high level of integrity. They speak truth. They are not yes men. They live in truth with themselves. The very acceptance of a leadership role is a great responsibility. It is both scary as well as exhilarating, because it gives you humongous satisfaction. Once you decide to become your leader, you cast off the shackles of fear and dependency that holds most people back and do not allow you to progress. Please set yourself on the path of becoming everything that you desire to do and try to become great leaders. Thank you.